What's up, wrestling fans? Webmaster Wade here, ringscoops.com. Tomorrow night is WWE Survivor Series on the Peacock Network. And I realized it's Saturday. I have not done my predictions yet. I normally do these as a podcast. Decided, you know what? I think more bang for my buck. I'll do a video. So, all right. Survivor Series. Who will survive? You got teams. You got either 4-on-4 or 5-on-5, depending on how they want to have the rules that year, right? 1990 was unique because all the survivors from each team went into an ultimate survivor match. Then 98, we had the Deadly Game Tournament. But, you know, since the 90s, Survivor Series hasn't really been the same as when it first started, right? Because it used to just be exclusively team competition. 91, I believe it was, Undertaker versus Hulk Hogan, if I'm not mistaken. I could be wrong. I think that was the match, right? That was one of the first times that they had a non-traditional Survivor Series match. I know 92 was definitely one event that didn't have all exclusive traditional matches, because you had Shawn versus Brett, and then of course Mr. Perfect stepping in for the Ultimate Warrior to team up with the Macho Man to take on Ric Flair and Razor Ramon. But Survivor Series growing up was one of my favorite events to tune into every year because of the team competition thing. They just dwindled it down, which sucks, you know, over the years. It's lost its prestige. It's lost its, you know, spark. They try to do the brand thing, you know, brand supremacy, Raw versus SmackDown. Sometimes they throw NXT in there. 2 years ago was a really good build. 2 years ago was a really good event. That really had the essence of what Survivor Series was built on. With a new wave of, you know, of talent and how the company runs, you know, having the three brands and whatnot. This year's Survivor Series, the build hasn't really been too spectacular in my opinion, but I'm still looking forward to the event. Big E and Roman Reigns, I think, will be the main event. I think it'll be the one to close the show. They have really built that match very well. I don't want to waste too much of your guys' time. I just kind of wanted to talk a little bit about Survivor Series there. Before I actually give my predictions for the event, real quick before we run into the predictions, I always ask this on social media, and I get interesting responses. So I want to ask all you guys here on this video, and you can leave a comment down below, not only with your predictions, but, you know, give me an answer to this question as well. When you watch pay-per-views, how do you traditionally watch pay-per-views? Do you watch them by yourself? Do you have a big party? Do you go to the movie theater? Do you go to a local pizzeria? How do you watch? What's your viewing habits for watching pay-per-views? And part two of that question, for instance, a two-part question, especially if you're having like a party, right? What kind of snacks do you do? What kind of meals do you do? Like for me, traditionally, I usually go for, you know, a good pizza, you know, for a pay-per-view. WrestleMania tradition for me, I make my famous chili cheese dip with tortilla chips. That's become a tradition now in my house, the Ring Scoops headquarters. You know, good plate of nachos, that's always good too, right? Some pretzel dogs. So what's your go-to pay-per-view snack, your go-to pay-per-view meal? And what are your viewing habits of pay-per-views? I'm very interested, you know, to get to know you guys. You guys know a lot about me because I'm an open book. I throw a lot of information out there about myself. But I want to know more about you guys. I want to make this a little bit more intimate. That's what Ring Scoops was built on 22 years ago when I started it, was making friends and having an interpersonal relationship with everybody that visits the website. So let's get to know each other. So now, without further ado, let's talk about the predictions, right? According to Wikipedia, we have got 7 matches lined up. It was 6 until yesterday, but they added the Battle Royal. 25-man Battle Royal. It is a dual-branded Battle Royal. The participants include AJ Styles, Angel, Angelo Dawkins, Apollo Crews, Cedric Alexander, Cesaro, Chad Gable, Commander Aziz, Dolph Ziggler, Drew Gulak, Eric, Humberto, Ivar, Jinder Mahal, my number one right there, Mansoor, Montez Ford, Omos, Otis, R-Truth, Ricochet, Robert Roode, Sami Zayn, Shanky, Shelton Benjamin, and T-Bar. I love a good Battle Royal. I know there's been a lot of jokes on social media, right? The winner of the Battle Royal is going to be exempt from the next round of releases and whatnot. It's funny stuff. It's good stuff right there. But, like I said, I'm a sucker for a good Battle Royal. You know, especially if you got a big guy like Omos in there. You know, that always is a really good formula with a Battle Royal. Is you got all those guys in there, and then you got some monster, right? Like Andre the Giant used to be the monster. Yokozuna, The Big Show, guys like that. Kane, you know. So we got Omos in there. But you know what? Commander Aziz is no small guy either. Imagine Omos and Commander Aziz going face-to-face. Be interesting. If I had to pick a winner for this, or you know what, I'm going to pick a top three, okay? Top three. Jinder Mahal, without a doubt. Otis. Don't count Otis out. Former Money in the Bank winner, right? And of course, there's AJ Styles. What if it came down between AJ and Omos? And AJ tells Omos, let me win this. And Omos says, I don't think so. And you kind of plant the seeds for them to have a feud down the road. Never know. Never know. But yeah, those are my three. I'm going to go with AJ, Jinder, and Otis. Next, we've got a... all these are like brand versus brand matches, so I'm just going to get that out of the way. So we got Intercontinental Champion, Shinsuke Nakamura, and Rick Boog. Going up against Damian Priest, who is the United States champion. I'm a big Shinsuke Nakamura fan, but his run as Intercontinental Champion has been lackluster, in my opinion. However, Damian Priest, I'm a big fan of his. He's growing on me huge. He's improving all the time. I think his title run is a lot better than Shinsuke Nakamura's title run. And I think there's a bigger upside for Damian Priest. So I think it's Damian Priest getting the victory in that match. We got RK-Bro, Randy Orton and Riddle, the Raw Tag Team Champions, going up against the Usos, Jimmy and Jay, the SmackDown Tag Team Champions. If you want to keep rolling with the bloodline and being on top, the Usos got to get the victory. They got to get the victory, right? But at the same time, RK-Bro, the bigger the wins, the more together they are, the bigger the turn down the road. I don't think we're going to have a clear-cut winner in this. There's going to be something going on. I don't think it's going to be a pin or a submission or anything like that. I think it might end up in some kind of DQ or something. Somebody's going to get involved. So I don't think there's going to be a winner straight up in that match. If anything, you know, maybe the Usos will win by some kind of, you know, deceit, right? We have got the champion versus champion match. Well, they're all really champion versus champion matches. My bad. We got Becky Lynch, the Raw Women's Champion, taking on Charlotte Flair, the SmackDown Women's Champion. And the audience is kind of split on this one. And they're leaning a little bit more towards being annoyed by these two going at it compared to the other half saying they're proving track records. It's going to be a good match. Who cares if they've fought each other many times? There, you got those two different camps of people, right? I'm kind of in the middle. I mean, I see both sides. They have fought each other way too many times. In 2021, I don't think we need to see this match. But on the bright side, you know it's going to be a good match. So, I mean, there's that 80% guaranteed that you're going to have a good match out of these two. It's going to be very telling to see not only who wins, but how they win. How long this match goes, what the finish is going to be. It's going to be very telling. We're going to find out, you know, really who the company is behind between these two, Becky Lynch and Charlotte Flair. Personally, I'm going to go with Becky Lynch. I think there's a bigger upside with Becky Lynch winning because she's just still fresh off this big return. She's got this enormous amount of heel heat. The transformation for her character is phenomenal. Each week, the promos, the looks, you know, everything that she's doing, the matches that she's had, they've been very entertaining. Charlotte Flair, I think she's lost a little bit of her, no pun intended, flair. So I'm going to go with Becky Lynch on that one. We got Big E versus Roman Reigns. The build for this has been great, especially the end of this week's SmackDown, the go-home episode of SmackDown. These two are going to kill each other tomorrow night at Survivor Series, and I'm looking forward to it. As much as I would love to see Big E get a win over Roman Reigns, don't see it happening. Big E, I don't see as the guy to finally beat Roman Reigns. I know it's not title versus title, so they could still have Roman lose and keep the belt, not lose too much heat. But he would lose a lot of heat, though. That's the thing. Because it's no longer just about, you know, oh, who's going to take the strap off of him. He's been undefeated for so many days since his return. Nobody has beaten him. Nobody has dominated him. So now you have a double thing for Roman Reigns. One, who's going to be big enough to be believable to beat him and take the title off of him. Big E at this point, not ready. Don't think it's him. Roman Reigns is my pick. Now we've got the two traditional Survivor Series matches. We have got the women's Team Raw, Bianca Belair, Rhea Ripley, Liv Morgan, Carmella, and Queen Zelina going up against Team SmackDown, Sasha Banks, Shayna Baszler, Shotzi, Natalya, and Toni Storm. Good blend of established talent and fresh talent, especially on the SmackDown side, because you got Sasha and Natalya, who are very seasoned. You got Shayna Baszler, who's like kind of like in that in-between part on the main roster. And then Shotzi and Toni Storm, newcomers to the main roster. On Team Raw, Carmella's the most seasoned out of, as far as being on the main roster, to clarify. Bianca Belair and Rhea Ripley have had a lot of success on the main roster. And then, of course, you got Queen Zelina, who's been around quite a bit, but really hasn't done that much in the ring. And then Liv Morgan, who 20 times a year seems like she's going to just about to get that push, and then they yank the carpet up. I got to go with Team SmackDown on this one. I really do. I got to go with Team SmackDown. I think there's a bigger upside with that team going for it, especially if they're going to continue this with Sasha and Shotzi. They've got a lot of really good stuff going on over on SmackDown. So if Team SmackDown wins, and let's say Sasha and Shotzi are like the final two, right? They're the sole survivors, or not sole. Sole's one. If they're the survivors for their team, they can argue over who did the most work or who's the reason why that team won. So you've got longevity in that one. So I'm going to go with Team SmackDown. And now the final match, the men's Survivor Series match. Team Raw is Seth Rollins, Finn Balor, Kevin Owens, Bobby Lashley, and Austin Theory. Going to get Team SmackDown. Drew McIntyre, Jeff Hardy, King Woods, Happy Corbin, and Sheamus. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 on 5. So let's kind of break this down with some of the talent, right? Seth Rollins over on Raw, phenomenal. Finn Balor, somewhat lost in the mix a little bit. He's always kind of been lost in the mix. Kevin Owens does whatever he wants to do. Bobby Lashley has definitely fallen since losing the belt, which is a travesty. Austin Theory is doing good stuff. Loving what they're doing with him on Raw. Team SmackDown, Drew McIntyre. I just kind of grown tired of Drew McIntyre this year. Jeff Hardy always will get a pop. Will always be able to do good stuff. He's just guaranteed a good time when Jeff Hardy's on the screen. King Woods, phenomenal. Everything they're doing with him. This King thing is working for him. Glad he won King of the Ring. He's going to be a major player to watch in 2022. So keep your eye out on that. Then, of course, you got Happy Corbin, who's the chucklehead. He's the funny, the comedy relief guy. And then you got Sheamus, who's kind of like, he's kind of like the homegrown version of Kevin Owens. Like, you know, just throw him anywhere you want him, throw him. What's the bigger upside, Team Raw or Team SmackDown? Well, you know, I think maybe Team Raw. I think Team Raw winning will be huge, especially for a guy like Austin Theory to be part of a team that wins like that. Bobby Lashley, very dominant. Bobby Lashley will probably take out Happy Corbin, which will pop the crowd because everybody hates Happy Corbin. And then Jeff Hardy's in that match to probably take a huge bump from a guy like Bobby Lashley. And then, you know, Drew McIntyre and Bobby Lashley, they can, you know, do a face-to-face, rekindle their whole thing a little bit, get a big pop out of that. Seth Rollins, Finn Balor, and Kevin Owens, I think are going to be your big wild cards here on that one. I'm going to go with Team Raw. I think Team Raw is going to get it. So, that's it, man. That's my thoughts on Survivor Series. My thoughts and my predictions. What are some of your favorite Survivor Series moments? I'm unloading a bunch of questions on you guys, I know. But, like I said, I just want to get to know you guys a lot more. You guys know me. You guys know a lot about me. I barely know anything about you, and I feel bad. It's a one-sided relationship here between Ring Scoops and all of you guys. So, what are some of your favorite matches in Survivor Series history, favorite moments? If you've attended Survivor Series in the past, let me know. What year did you go to Survivor Series, or what years if you went to, you know, more than one? I went to 2007 in Miami, which was interesting. And it's funny because, like, a buddy of mine, the DA, he really wanted to see MVP's floaty. And it was the one time MVP didn't come out with the floaty. And he was very disappointed in that. So that sucks for DA. And to this day, I still tease him about that. But yeah, there you go. All right, don't forget, leave a comment down below with your thoughts on Survivor Series. Any of the questions I asked, if you have any answers for that you want to share, leave a comment down below. And so there you go. Don't forget, check out Ring Scoops on social media. Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, TikTok, all those at Ring Scoops. Go to ringscoops.com. You'll get all the links on there. If you're wondering, is this account a real Ring Scoops account? Go to ringscoops.com and you can confirm that way. And also twitch.tv/ringscoops for live Ring Scoops feeds. We do a lot of traveling. We play video games. We do all kinds of good stuff. We're going to be doing some cooking streams too pretty soon. So don't forget to check that out. And of course, anchor.fm/ringscoops for all the Ring Scoops podcasts. We got some interviews coming up pretty soon too. Some good interviews lined up with some up and coming talent on the independent scene from all over the world. Mexico, Canada, United Kingdom, and a whole lot more. So stay tuned for more awesomeness right here on ringscoops.com. I'm the webmaster, Wade Needham, saying until next time, thank you, good night, and be cool.